Welcome, Cyber Wizards. Today, we merge the path of data and security, unraveling the nuances of safeguarding our digital landscape. As security data engineer in InfoSec, I don't claim to have all the answers, but I have a unique perspective towards how this domain works and how we can build the robust digital defense. Our goal today is to explore the synergy between data and security, ensuring every interaction is safe and convenient. Are you ready for this journey towards secure, seamless, and digital experiences?
Yes.
Yeah, you're hearing that. So my topic is data-led approach to cybersecurity. Ever wondered what happens behind the scene of the world of cybersecurity? Join me as I unveil the insight on my journey at Just Eat. Let's uncover some mysteries and talk about how we can make sure that data is safe. Before kick this thing off, can I ask a few questions? How often do you think the security of data? No? I know. Do you ever wonder how we tackle ever-growing challenges when it comes to data in cybersecurity? Not really? Do you ever wonder if there is any easier way to analyze the data, which we have a lot, I think, in security? And most importantly, who here is looking for something where they can use it and analyze this thing, have a strategy with them when they leave this room?
Yes.
Thank you. So let me start with what's in the agenda today. I will be exploring some of the challenges. Then I will be describing the strategy and then implementation of those data-led strategy. And always we have to talk about something future. So we will talk in something about future and some conclusion of all those things. I will be opening for Q&A later on. And then we will be wrapping this thing up. So starting with exploring cybersecurity challenges. In our digitized world, the significance of cybersecurity cannot be overstated. Today, I have to delve into the realm of cybersecurity and highlight some prevalent issues like data overload, insider threat modeling, and delayed threat detection and insider threats, and proposing a data-led strategy as a beacon of hope. Shall we start with data overload? I think you guys need to know what happens with data. So one of the primary predicament haunting the cybersecurity domain is data overload. In an era where information is generated at unprecedented rate, we find ourselves flooded with data, large amount of security data. And the challenge lies that not only that it's the quantity, it's the how they are not able to analyze those data. So inability to analyze and manage this flood. Traditional methods, often reactive and rule-based, fall short in the scope of this sheer volume of data, leading to an overwhelming task of distinguishing between normal behavior and potential threats. So that's why we have to find some solution, and we will be describing the solution later on in this talk. Moving to another issue, which is delayed threat detection. Relentless evolution of cyber threats presents another inflation challenge, delayed threat detection. Traditional methods such as signature-based evolution and rule-based systems were once effective, now show signs of strain. And identification of security breach is often delayed, allowing malicious actors to operate within our systems for extended periods. Reactive response strategies were once norm are now proving as their liabilities and increasing the vulnerabilities to the sophisticated cyber threats. Allow me to illustrate the gravity of issue with the real life case study. In recent cyber attack, a major financial institution due to delayed threat detection, resulted with substantial financial losses and reputational damage. The traditional reactive approach failed to swiftly identify and mitigate the breach, and highlighting this critical, and that's highlight that we have to have a proactive approach to the, towards it. Insider threat. One of the most insidious challenges faced by an organization is difficulty tackling insider threat. The notion of threat can happen within our own organization adds a layer of complexity. Identifying malicious activities originating from individual within the organization possesses a significant challenge. The lack of effective mechanism to prevent or mitigate insider threats compound the issue, leaving the organization exposed for a potential internal risk. I have talked about so much problem, like you are like, why we are doing this? So now, as we acknowledge these frightening challenges, it's imperative to shift the focus towards solution-oriented strategy, and the path forward lies with data-less strategy. That's my talk. And leverages the power of information for a more robust and adaptive power cybersecurity posture. In a world where data is target and a shield, a data-led strategy becomes a backbone for effective cybersecurity measure. By harnessing the wealth of information at disposal, and we can confront the challenges head-on. So we are here now discussing about the data-led strategy. Before I delve into that, the strategies, I want to point out why this shift is crucial, why this shift is needed in the first place. So I want to discuss about what the data-driven strategy, why the data-driven strategy is important. So starting with navigating complexity, the digital realm is a complex ecosystem of data networks, constantly evolving. In a response to a sophisticated cyber threat, our data strategy becomes crucial, and as it allows us to navigate this complexity with agility and adaptability. Recognizing that a traditional method might fall short in the face of modern challenges. Second is strategic defense, where imagine strategically defending against emerging cyber threats, not just reacting, but also anticipating and proactively mitigating the potential risk. This is precisely what a data-led strategy empowers an organization to achieve. By utilizing data analytics, we gain insight that enables us to develop defense measures and strategically staying one step ahead of our cyber adversaries. Let me share a compelling statistics that emphasizes the impact of strategic defense. According to a recent study, organizations implementing a data-led strategy experience a 30% reduction in the average time to detect and respond to cyber threats, compared to those who are relying solely on traditional method. This is strategic approach enhances overall cyber resilience and providing a tangible advantage in ever-evolving digital landscape. And the next topic where I want to discuss is role of data. The pivotal role of data is in the cybersecurity landscape cannot be overstated. It's not just information, it's about transforming that information into shield. And by actively defending our digital realm, in the face of cyber threat, the strategic utilization of data becomes linchpin of the effective threat detection, incident response, and overall cyber resilience. So we know the importance of data-driven decision strategy. Now we can talk about discuss how these strategies can help the previous issues which we have talked about. Effective data management. An effective data management is a system and a data-driven system culture underpinned by education and skill development as they are instrumental in addressing the challenge of data overload. By leveraging advanced analytics and artificial intelligence, organizations can streamline the process of ingesting, managing, analyzing, and reporting on vast security data set in real time. This ensures more precise and proactive cybersecurity approach. At JET, the task of analyzing billions of customer interactions for security threats indeed challenging. However, by adopting a data-led strategy and implementing advanced analytics, we can identify unusual pattern quickly. This not only enhances the data security, but also aligns with the wisdom of former AIDevOps leader, if you have to do something 3 times automated. And this approach allows us to automate repetitive tasks, freeing up resources for more strategic events and further strengthening our cybersecurity posture. Moving on to address the delayed threat detection, we have a strategy called swift threat detection, which is more proactive in nature. And by leveraging the vast and curated data sets, machine learning models, we can responsibly implement to enable a real-time identification and response to security breaches. This approach replaces the reactive nature of traditional methods with a more proactive stance, significantly minimizing the window of opportunity for malicious actors. In the context of JET, our system had a malware that went undetected due to traditional method. If an AI-driven detection approach would have identified and neutralized it faster, this has not only reduced data risk, but also enhances the overall security posture of the system. We will discuss about the insider threat mitigation for the insider threat issue. When it comes to insider threat, a data strategy proves a game changer. Behavioral analytics ingrained in approach allows organization to create a detailed profile of user behavior. The dynamic profiling facilitates the identification of anomalies and potential insider threat. By continually monitoring user behavior in organization, we can prevent and mitigate risk from arising from within and ensuring a more and trustworthy environment, more secure and trustworthy environment. To detect insider threat at JET, behavioral analytics can identify unusual data access pattern by employees, focusing solely on the security related behaviors. Privacy is ensured, limiting monitoring to work-related activities and being transparent with employees about what monitoring policies are. This approach balances the effective threat detection with respect for employees' privacy. So that's how we balance privacy versus. I'm talking for a long time. If you have any question, I can and then I can go for implementation. Okay. Now, implementation of data-led strategy. We know the significance of why it's needed, how it can help, and we have to be practical about it. So let's start weaving the journey of data-led strategy in the cybersecurity, and I will be breaking it down into easy talk where you can understand, because I'm very new to the InfoSec team, and you guys are new to data, I guess. So starting with data starts with data collection, data storage, and data processing, where first we like to gather the information we have and with the company safety, and then identify what data really matter for cybersecurity, such as log data, network traffic data, user behavior data. Setting up the system that constantly collect the data, it's like regularly health check for the company. Then once we decide what data we are working on, we start with the data storage. So we all have all the information, but we don't know where to place now. So we have to find a way. That So we need some storage, and think about at is at a secure place at your home where you can store this data. And in this case, we consider using data lake for flexibility. It is having a storage space, but it can adapt. And making just make sure when you're storing a data, it should be safe and complies with the privacy regulation. We don't want any data which is causing trouble or not going through GDPR or anything. Then we start with, we started with data. Now we have to know the data, because if we start and we don't go in and dig deeper that what we are going to do about data, then it comes to data analysis and threat detection. Data processing. Once we store the data, moving to data processing, it's like to getting tools organized and ready for the project. Cleaning up the data, just like tidying up with your tools. Get rid of unnecessary noise, handle the missing pieces, normalize the data, and ensure that data is a clean canvas when you start and do the analysis on it. Now, getting to know the data. Data analysis is about finding insight in your data. It's like shining the light of hidden patterns. This involves statistical analysis, machine learning, and basically using tools to uncover valuable information. Start easy with anomaly detection and pattern recognition. Spot the potential threats, and without getting lost in tech maze. Then we go to threat detection. Once we have the analysis in hand, we will do the threat detection. Think it as a watchful eye for potential cybersecurity threat. It's like looking for the first sign of trouble on the horizon. Use the insight for the analysis and spot the thing which can cause problem at all. Anomaly detection and pattern recognition can be helpful tool in this case. Once we know the data, how we grow with the data, because it can grow tremendously fast with security. So we have to do response and mitigation, and there will be a continuous improvement on that one. Now, what we do when there's a threat, it's the response where that's the place where response and mitigation comes in place. It's creating a plan of action for your cybersecurity strategy, develop ways to respond to threat and minimize their impact. This might involve installing alerting system and whatnot. Think it as an alarm to warn about any potential danger. And then once we have response and mitigation in place, we have to go for continuous improvement and treat it as a strategy, like a living, evolving plan. Refine and improve based on feedback and results. It's like upgrading your strategy to be more effective over time. Remember, this is a team effort, and you have to need people who are cybersecurity experts, data experts, and have a good IT infrastructure. Train your team well and follow the best practices for your data in cybersecurity. Consider it as a guidebook for the all digital security team. In a nutshell, as we embark on the data-led strategy in cybersecurity, remember, every step is a building block. It might seem like a lot, but with right mindset and trained team and a clear plan, you will gradually tackle each phase in your data journey.
Thank you.
Future trends and data-led strategies. So no discussion today can happen without addressing influence of AI in our life. So you tell me, I am very new to cybersecurity. You tell me, what are the future trends for cybersecurity world? I have one in my armor, but tell me more so that I can learn about from you guys.
How about quantum computing?
Yeah.
Quantum computing. So I'm just taking the names so that I can do the research. Any future trends which you have in mind? Yeah?
I'm actually a bit scared that in the world where AI is so easily accessible and any university student can literally find data from everything they know about your company and what they know about other companies with zero hour abilities, that they can affect your company and your data so much easier now in a much robust way. How do you make sure that your data protection, the cybersecurity and data thing, it actually works?
It's like a question. We can answer.
So the question is, how do we make sure that the data protection, cybersecurity strategy that is correct for the data actually works?
So we have to make sure it's everyone has, no one has individual access and all, and we have to give something where it's not open to everyone, it's just limited to people, and we have to try that. So let's start with the future trends, which I have to discuss. So I won't bore you with the commonplace discussion about omnipresence of AI. Instead, I just have to explore one topic. Today, there is one fascinating intersection of technology, which is generative AI with reverse engineering for context of cybersecurity. So Gen AI, we are listening about this thing for almost 2 years now. Generative AI is a subset of artificial intelligence where system can generate new data samples that have similar input. It's like teaching a machine to be creative, to generate new ideas based on pattern it has learned. Now let's delve into how Gen AI can aid the reverse engineering in cybersecurity. Firstly, it can help in automation of malware analysis. Gen AI can automate the process of understanding complex malicious software. It generates new data sample based on patterns it can learn from malwares, aiding in understanding the malware's behavior, origin, and potential impact. Secondly, Gen AI can excel in pattern recognition and prediction, which I talked about, like we need pattern recognition a lot. So it identifies the pattern of malware code that may be missed in human analysis. It can also predict future malware behavior based on this pattern and leading to more accurate identification of potential vulnerabilities and effective countermeasures. Lastly, it helps on adaptive learning and generation. So as Gen AI analyzes more malware samples, it learns and improves, and it's the direction and detection and analysis of all the capabilities it has. It can generate new data or even potential malwares for testing and strengthening our countermeasures. This is a continuous learning and generation and make it more effective over the time. Gen AI can be a powerful tool to revolutionize the field of reverse engineering in cybersecurity, make it more efficient, accurate, and adaptive to the ever-revolving landscape of cyber threats. So I will give some call to action to you guys. Apply the insights, what we have learned today. Use the data-led strategies. Fortify these digital practices into your organization and security. Share the vision, share the knowledge, whatever you gain. Try to influence your network to adopt proactively to cybersecurity measures. Stay ahead. Try to embrace the emerging trends in cybersecurity. Keep learning, keep adapting to ensure ongoing protection against ever-evolving threats. In conclusion, exploration of cybersecurity reveals challenges in data overload, data delayed threat, and insider threat. And a robust data-led strategy emerges as a beacon of hope. As we implement these strategies, We embrace and embrace future trends. We like Gen AI. Remember your role, secure your digital space, share your knowledge, and stay informed. Let's collectively shape a safer digital future. Thanks for your journey.
Yep.
Thanks. Hi, Disha. How are you?
Hi, boss.
So what is, can you tell us more about what is OCSF and what challenges does it try to solve and what is it?
So OCSF is one of the data models which is normalized for all the security people. So it's a framework which you use. OCSF stands for Open Cybersecurity Framework. And it has been made, it has been developed so that we can model it and use it for our own goodwill. So right now we are using this thing in our project as well, where we are trying to model some data which we got. Right now we are using one source and we have made some data modeling using the OCSF model. So one of the issue which we got, because we are doing it manually, it takes lots of time, but there are use cases which you can use, like AWS has Security Data Hub, which does this job for us instead of we doing it manually. So there are things which we can outsource if we can't have it done at our, we don't have data engineers, then we can do it.
Yeah, so for reference, one of the challenges is that if you have like one data source or two, that's not really that hard. You join them together and do your analytics. But if you want to have security as a single pane of glass and have to do all these ETLs and do all the mapping to these data, it becomes overly complex. So a whole bunch of companies came together to create it like this InfoSec data model. So as long as the data is within this framework, you can basically enrich it and analyze it into a single sort of model of it, which is really, really helpful because that's one of the bigger challenges that we've seen. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Any other questions this year? That's one more.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, just a quick question about the framework, really, and how much it links in with the existing models like the Common Information Model in Splunk.
So Splunk is actually a member of OCSF.
This is your talk.
Yeah,
Why don't you answer that question?
So Splunk is already part of OCSF, and they all whatever data goes in through Splunk is already OCSF model. Recognized, and if you want, you can't do it on your own. There's always AWS Security Hub, which will help you do that modeling for you without any issue. Thanks, Greg.
One more question. Yeah, we have one more question here.
Hi, Ray. Hi, Ray. Nice talk, by the way. Could I ask, how do you make sure that the model used in cybersecurity protections, let's say, for example, that the data is as clean as possible? As you know, nowadays, you can get really polluted data, if I'm allowed to say that, sometimes in certain models. And then obviously that would actually compromise the model for any sort of detections at the end of the day.
So once data is in OCSF model already, then you have to do the cleaning. It can't be done automatically. So you have to do your cleaning bit. It's just they model it, and then it gets ingested in your warehouse or in your data lake. And then you have to do the cleaning bit, and then you can do the analysis on top of it. Hope this answers your question.
Any more questions? Oh, that's one more.
Hi, Disha. Thank you very much for your talk. I remember you had 5 steps. The first one was data analysis, first one data collection, fourth one data analysis. Would there be any data discovery at any or many of those stages?
For data discovery, mostly during the data collection, we do the data discovery where we try to discover which data you want to work with. So that's what you can call data collection or data discovery. It's same.
And then data structuring would be step three?
It will be more on data processing part, where you will be normalizing everything.
So for the framework we are talking about...
data processing.
Yes, would it be straightforward then, and most data would already be in that format, so you would then need to do data discovery?
So whatever the sources you have, you already have some sources, and you want to analyze and do some discoveries on the top of it. So you start with some data point, data source, and then you start with how you are going to and have this thing worked out. So once you have the data discovery done with the source, then you start analyzing what data can help, how data is going to be looked like. So you do all the pre-work before you really start doing the modeling part.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Any more questions? No. Oh, one more.
Yeah, thanks very much for that. That was an excellent
talk.
Thank you. I was just wondering, in real life, how does this look in an organization? What's the split between like data scientists, engineers, and security analysts?
So in my team, I'm one of the data engineer. I'm the only data engineer, and I have a team of four, and they are very good security engineer. So they help me a lot. So we are working towards for this project in six months, and it's going well. And they are capable of doing, because security engineers is kind of come into that Venn diagram where they share some of the knowledge of data engineering, so it can be helpful.
Thank you. Any
but questions? We have to have one data engineer who can help them.
Any more questions? Okay. Yeah, let's thank Disha for a great talk. Thank you.
Thank you.